God, he sure looks like a creep.
I protested at that time. I was not allowed legal representation. During that very short and sweet hearing, I really don't know what this situation is about. Nobody has told me anything except that I'm accused of murdering a policeman. I know nothing more than that, and I do request someone to come forward to give me a legal assistance.
Were you ever in the Free Cuba Movement or whatever that's called?
That's the Fair Play for Cuba Committee.
What did you do in Russia? And what happened to your eye?
He seems pretty cool to me for a man under pressure like that.
A policeman hit me.
Give me the willies. Okay, come on, sugar plums. It's past your bedtime. Oh, Maddie. Get a hold of yourself.
So, several hours after the assassination, he disturbed
Lee
Harvey Oswald.
A fine man.
Instead of the Marines, he apparently became fascinated by communism.
He is still believed to be a dedicated Marxist and a fanatical supporter of Fidel Castro and ultra-left-wing causes. He spent last summer in New Orleans and was arrested there in a brawl with anti-Castro Cuban exiles.
And apparently, Bob, Oswald had been passing out pro-Castro pamphlets.
Yeah, sorry to disturb you this late.
Sorry, I'm watching.
Yeah, matter of routine, but we better get on this Oswald connection in New Orleans right away.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I want you to check out his record, find any friends or associates from last summer. And let's meet with the senior assistants and investigators day after tomorrow, all right?
Will that be on Sunday?
Sunday, yeah, at 11.
All right.
Thanks, Lou.
I would say that without any doubt, he's the killer. The law says beyond a reasonable doubt and to a moral certainty.